Hello, thank you for joining us on Court TV News at 7. I am Frank Omalape. Former President Olusegun Obasanjo's dispute with the People's Democratic Party has finally reached its peak with his departure from the party. Obasanjo, who spoke to newsmen in Abeokuta about his exit from the party, also tore his membership card as a practical demonstration of his exit from the party. A correspondent, Olajumoke Olatiji, has more in this report.
Speculations have been rife over the continued presence of former President Olusegun Obasanjo in the PDP or if he's moving to the APC. But the former president, in his usual manner of dropping a major surprise, indeed made known his decision to leave the PDP. But unlike what many Nigerians have expected, he says he's leaving the PDP for what he termed as a lack of clear-cut direction and failure of leadership, but not for any other party, but rather to continue to play his role as a statesman.
I am no more a politician, I'm a statesman, both internally and externally.
He added that his role as a statesman from now on will be to work for the continued advancement of Nigeria and its people. With the exit of the former president from the People's Democratic Party now a reality, the Ogun State chapter of the party has also quickly moved to suspend him. But will this be the end of the saga? Only time will tell. Olajumoke Olatiji, Court TV News, Abeokuta.
Meanwhile, the Ogun State chapter of the People's Democratic Party has announced the expulsion of former President Olusegun Obasanjo from the party. The PDP's announcement came few hours after the former president dramatically announced his exit from the People's Democratic Party. His expulsion was announced by the state chairman of the party, Bayo Dayo.
His unabated anti-party activities, unbecoming of a highly celebrated party man engaged in by Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, the totality of the executive, leaders, and members of the People's Democratic Party, PDP family in Ogun State, hereby state categorically, as from today, Monday, 16th of February, 2015, Olusegun Aremu Obasanjo stands expelled and excommunicated from the party, thereby losing all rights, previous privileges, and respect of our teaming party members. Must no longer be seen from the prism of a PDP leader. Indeed, he seems to have lost all sense of proper behavior expected of a man who previously used and abused the opportunity provided him by PDP.
The chairman, board of trustees of the People's Democratic Party, Tony Adeniyi, says the party leadership will not miss former President Olusegun Obasanjo. Adeniyi spoke to journalists after a meeting of PDP leaders at the presidential villa, insists that it was within Obasanjo's right to leave the party. He, however, maintained that the party's fortunes will not be affected by the exit of the former president. The defense headquarters say former President Olusegun Obasanjo is an embarrassment to the military. The DHQ made the comment in a statement posted on its Facebook page while reacting to a statement credited to the former president that the general elections were postponed to enable the president use the service chiefs for a tenure extension in an electronic mail on Monday. The defense headquarters accused the former president of politicizing serious national security and military issues. The defense headquarters said that while Obasanjo's intentions remain unclear, his motives for making such utterances were less than noble, the statement stressed, that Obasanjo's claims were false. It also said it is surprising that Obasanjo opted to ignore the assurances by the defense authorities in a statement that the military will continue to be apolitical. The military said while it desires to accord respect to Obasanjo and his views, the statement credited to him did not reflect the standard of discipline expected from a former general of his status. The defense authority said the world has moved beyond the mentality of Obasanjo, insisting that the military personnel of today were better equipped in the era of training, education, exposure to have a better appreciation of democracy and its importance to national prosperity. The presidency has accused former President Olusegun Obasanjo of plotting with some named Nigerians to disrupt the forthcoming general elections and install an interim government in the country. It insists that contrary to his position, the former president is only interested in returning to power through unconstitutional means. Spokesman for President Jonathan Ruben Abachi said in a statement that Obasanjo has been attacking the president's integrity for the purpose of self-promotion. He also maintained that President Jonathan has no intention of seeking to win the election through foul means and will continue to support the Independent National Electoral Commission and other relevant federal agencies in their bid for a successful election. And now the People's Democratic Party presidential candidate in the 2015 general elections, Goodluck Jonathan, and his all-progressive Congress, Muhammadu Buhari, may meet before the March 28 presidential polls to calm unwarranted tensions and polity. A source close to the presidency says efforts have been made to broker a meeting between the two leaders expected to hold outside the country, aimed at establishing a rapport between them before the election. The source further disclosed that the move is geared towards checking the widening divisions among Nigerians and the unwarranted apprehension in the land. Meanwhile, the PDP has called on all political parties and other stakeholders in the electoral process to join hands with the Independent National Electoral Commission to make the 2015 general elections a success. The PDP National Publicity Secretary, Olusegun Obasanjo, in a statement in Abuja on Sunday says all parties must come together in the interests of the nation and ensure that measures that create an environment for credible, free and fair elections were put in place. And now the People's Democratic Party Presidential Campaign Organization has asked former President Olusegun Obasanjo to stop playing God over his numerous criticism of President Goodluck Jonathan. The Director of Media and Publicity of the campaign organization, Femi Fanikade, debunked the allegations, saying the former president, under whom he served as Minister of Aviation and Special Assistance on Public Communication, was trying to play God. Fanikade, while speaking at a press briefing in Abuja, says his former boss and trying in vain to control the president. He added that the problem between the two members of the ruling party has nothing to do with Nigeria, and called on the former president to leave Nigeria out of the issues between him and the president.
Again, it is ironic that President Obasanjo has accused President Jonathan of having a grand plan to stay in power at all costs and by all means. Yet, it is the same Obasanjo that tried to stay in power for a third term, even though the Nigerian constitution specifically forbade it. He tried all he could to change the constitution, but the whole thing failed and he was compelled to leave power. After Jonathan came to power, Obasanjo not only tried to control and teleguide him, but he also asked him to do a number of things that were simply wrong and unacceptable. It is for President Goodluck Jonathan himself to divulge those things, and I'm sure that he will do so at the appropriate time. Needless to say, President Jonathan refused to be teleguided and told what to do, even though at all times he showed Obasanjo maximum respect and accorded him all the privileges, access, and courtesies that is due to a former head of state and a father and mentor.
European Union Election Observation Mission has hailed the deposition of President Goodluck Jonathan on the May 29 handover date. Chief Election Observer of the mission, Santiago Fierce, described it as a good move in the aftermath of the postponement of the elections by 6 weeks. Fizas, who spoke with State House correspondents after meeting with Jonathan at the presidential villa, said he was impressed with the commitment of both sides to electoral process. He said he met with the presidential candidate of the All Progressive Congress, Muhammadu Buhari, twice, and the president to exchange views about the elections. And now the All Progressive Congress has accused those who are mortally afraid of the 2015 general elections of sponsoring the circulation of leaflets urging the people of Gombe State to stay away from the polling booth on election days or risk being in trouble. In a statement in Lagos by its National Publicity Secretary, Lai Mohammed, the party said it cannot put anything beyond the People's Democratic Party and the Goodluck Jonathan administration because of their desperation to ensure that the general elections did not hold at all cost. The party said even the attack on Gombe on Saturday was a suspect, wondering how Boko Haram insurgents would drive on the highway from Maiduguri to Gombe in a convoy of many vehicles without being spotted or stopped at the myriad of military checkpoints dotting the areas. APC said it was curious that the Boko Haram terrorists, who have never mentioned elections in their regular videos on YouTube, suddenly started campaigning against the conduct of the elections. The party also noted that the local government elections in Yobe, one of the hotbeds of the Boko Haram insurgency, went without any incident in 2013, indicating that there had not been a systematic campaign by the insurgents to attack voters. APC said the alarm raised by Michael Mary, the coordinator of the National Information Center, that some female suicide bombers might strike at polling units during the elections fit into the PDP Jonathan administration's opposition stronghold depopulation strategy. The party added that the federal government does not want the elections to hold due to a fear of massive defeat, while also disclosing that Ghana used the PVCs during its latest elections without any problem. The All Progressive Congress has raised an alarm over an alleged directive ordering the withdrawal of customs, immigration and other security personnel from the country's borders post in Kebbi and Katsina State. It wonders what purpose such a directive is meant to serve. In a statement in Lagos by its National Publicity Secretary, Lai Mohammed, the party said the verbal directive led to the total withdrawal of the stated personnel from the border post in the two states, leaving the post unmanned. APC wondered who gave the order and for what purpose, and asked the federal government to immediately tell Nigerians what happened. The party said with no one left to man the borders in the affected areas for as long as the directive lasted, which is yet to be determined, anything could have happened. The party added that such a directive was given verbally so that there will be no record of it, and asked if the order is to allow free entry of contraband goods, election materials, weapons or terrorists. You're still watching Court TV News at 7. We'll take a short break. We'll be back with more stories after this time out. Stay with us.
Don't you wish your mommy was fine like mine?
Yeah.
Don't you wish your mommy was smart like mine?
Yeah.
Don't you?
Don't you wish your mommy could laugh like mine?
And that's why every mom should take 3 crowns milk with low cholesterol to help stay fit and healthy so she can take extra care of her family.
Don't you wish your wifey was hot like mine?
3 crowns now comes in powder.
If you're just joining us, this is Court TV News at 7, live from our studios in Lagos, Nigeria. For more information on our news and other programs, like our Facebook page, it's facebook.com/CourtTVNews. You can as well follow at Court TV News NG. And for live streaming, log on to www.youtube.com/CourtTV/News. And now the Road Transport Employees Association of Nigeria is demanding the resignation of the chairman of the Independent National Electoral Commission, Atayo Ojega. This, it says, is the only way to guarantee credible election on March 28 and April 11. The national president of the Transporters Union, Musa Isiwele, made the group's position known in an interview with Court TV News in Abuja.
I feel Martin Allah to arrest the gas mine so that they do the right thing. But if they do the wrong thing, it's going to plug the country into a crisis. Because if you have my own opinion, my own personal opinion, with all these leakages that have come out after the guy said, I'm very ready, 100% ready before even the state council meeting. And then I come back and said, he's busy not to show it. Later, we discover that even the cutting message is on rapid, he should resign and let sleeping dog lie. Because if he after this election, a lot of people may not believe is the outcome. They will be taking it as a manipulation. So that is my own opinion.
The governorship candidate of the All Progressive Grand Alliance in Zamfara State has advised his rivals in the race, Abdulaziz Yari of All Progressive Congress APC, Mahmudu Shinkafi of the People's Democratic Party PDP, to respect the peace accord endorsed by all political parties, three of them. Shinkafi said at a news conference in Gusau that the initiative led by the Minister of Defense General Ali Gusau was a development worth honoring by all because of the caliber of people that summoned the meeting. He reminded the politicians of the charge to make their supporters conduct orderly campaigns while they agree to accept the outcome of the elections. And now Nigeria's military authorities say troops have cleared Monguno and its environs of insurgents. Defense headquarters say through its Twitter feeds that soldiers took over the town from Boko Haram after a coordinated air and land assault. It said a number of insurgents operating around Baga were also captured during the military operations alongside truckloads of food and logistics. The military added that the land and air assault is still ongoing with soldiers advancing to other locations and communities meant to be cleared. Meanwhile, the federal government has distributed relief materials to people displaced from Chibok and other parts of Borno State that are presently taking refuge in the federal capital territory, Abuja. Finance Minister Ngozi Okojie-Iweala led the government delegation to Kuje, a satellite town in the FCT, to hand over the materials to the internally displaced persons. She affirmed the commitment of the President Jonathan administration to supporting the displaced person while also expediting efforts towards restoring security in their communities to enable them return home soonest. The minister was accompanied by the Director General of the National Emergency Management Agency, Mohammed Sani Sidi, also disclosed that arrangement has been made for some of the affected children to be moved to unity schools across the country under the Safe School Initiative. Responding on behalf of the IDPs, spokesman for the Chibok community in the FCT, Gapani Yagana, appreciated the federal government for the continued support given to them. You're still watching Court TV News at 7. We'll take another break shortly. We'll be back with more stories outside Nigeria. Stay with us.
You can now watch Court TV News live from anywhere in the world on our website, www.courttvnews.com. Click on Live TV on our website and watch us live.
And welcome to Court TV Primetime News.
To follow us on Twitter, click on Twitter icon on our website. And Facebook, click on the Facebook and YouTube to see all our previous news production. You can also watch us live on YouTube. Click Court TV, leave a space, then news. Court TV News, a 24-hour news station.
Outside Nigeria now, following the beheading of 21 hostages by ISIS, the Egyptian military is currently carrying out airstrikes against Islamic State militants. Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi said his country reserved the right to punish murderers as they call a meeting of security chiefs and declare 7 days of mourning. Footage is released by ISIS online shows 21 handcuffed hostages beheaded in a coastal area in the Libyan province of Tripoli. In the latest issue of ISIS online magazine Dabiq, the group says the same number of Egyptian hostages were being held in Libya. The Coptic Church has also issued a statement saying it was confident the killers will be brought to justice as a prestigious Cairo-based seat of Islamic learning denounced the barbaric killings. And as a wrap on Court TV News at 7, many thanks for watching. Don't forget, join us at 9:45 p.m. for our primetime bulletins. I am Frank Omalape. Good evening.